Okay guys, we're back and we're still doing this video. This is the part two. And we gotta go make some cash now. Oh my god. That's destroyed. Can we still control it though? Okay, that's good. You know what? I think what I might do, set up some wheels and get the wheels set up, and then do a sniper tower center where you can drive the sniper tower, but then you can also set it up for this mode. And it'll just be set up to where you can get up in the sniper tower, activate it, then get going. Stop being stuck. Activate switch. Oh, there's lights. Is there anything else we can switch on? I'm just trying to switch on anything that might help me. Hey, there we go. How do they do this, though, is my question. Oh! I can make an even smaller turret with that, then. Yeah, I think Wyatt left, which sucks. I can do a smaller turret with that concept then. Yeah, sorry if it's pretty boring because of, we're just having to take out the zombies right now, which sucks because we don't have any vehicles anymore because Wyatt's got, like, destroyed and that other guy's is destroyed too. How much do I have? 3,000. Random weapon. Whoop! Whoop, 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 whoop. Run. Pick it up. There we go. Oh my god. None of the zombies we have right now. At least they're all lining up. Come on. Can't pick up these. Okay, there we go. Go. Random weapon. Pick this up. I'll get my last upgrade next. Okay, we gotta go find the last of the zombies. Okay, so I kind of got an idea on how I can do this. That is actually not a bad idea for the how to set up the turret. So that is something to keep in mind. So now my turrets aren't so bulky, because most of the time my turrets have been bulky, and that's my problem right now. So now I can actually fix them and make them better looking. And see, with that, then we can modify and make better vehicles. But I'll need to get the sniper tower vehicle set up soon if we lose this round. If we lose this game mode. So if we do, then I'll start working on that vehicle. I do not know how you guys feel about me building on video, because I think you guys might think it's boring because I don't speed up my stuff. So I might not do it. I might not build on video because of how boring it can be. But the sniper tower, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up tires, and then it will kind of snap together. It'll connect, and then you unconnect the pieces. Like, there'll be the wheels that connect to the actual base of it, and those unconnect, and that's set up, and then it'll be a sniper tower just above the area. So then the sniper tower you can set up anywhere you want, and then you can just stand on it and nothing can really affect it. You'll just have to, I might have to work on it though, because there might be problems with overrunning of zombies. So I'll have to look at it. These houses need to be enterable though. That'd be awesome for especially the zombie mode, because then you could go in the house and like kind of bunker down. Have some small vehicles like go into the actual building. That's what they need to do. That'd be great if they had like the ability to go in the house, and then you can also still destroy it just from the inside or outside. It might take a little bit longer though. I think that's what they should do. Make it a little bit longer if they're gonna do it to where you can go actually inside this building. But the developer will have to work on that though, and I mean, that's a lot of detail to put inside a house too. I mean, he could see about getting some other people involved with it. Where are these other zombies? Oh, there they are. They've been following me. At least some of them have. Okay, three more. I just kind of ran around the city until some zombies found me. So I might do the same thing. Because we still have three left, and I gotta get those three dead. They gotta die. In fact, let's see if we can do the fire upgrade on this or not. No, we can't. Not yet. We got 980. The sniper tower build, though, I might make a, when I do it, I think, I'm not quite sure. I don't know how I want to do it yet. I kind of think that I want to do it to where the wheels kind of allow it to roll, and then you switch it to another mode and it'll pull up and basically switch into the tower mode. But then there's also the whole deal of you can set up the wheels and then set up a system underneath the box for the sniper tower, then have that set up and go up. So I don't know which one I should do yet. I definitely need to make a ramp to go up it and all of that, but I'll have to play and test it, if anything. I'm still trying to find those last zombies, wherever the hell they are. Yeah, see, over here we can't go in, which sucks. I mean, I could get a vehicle and just drive around, but that's going to waste some money. Because the vehicles are great and all. It's just they're not the best for everything. Zombie, zombie, zombie. Where are you? Don't worry, guys. I'm really looking. We only have 3 left until wave 15. This is really hard. Basically, the weaponry, though, is good for the big zombies. The vehicles and all that. So, I might set up that sniper tower with something like that. Not quite sure what we'll do yet with that. But I'm definitely going to make something for this mode that is basically a sniper tower. And I might start putting my stuff on the workshop. But I'm going to have to kind of look into it a little bit more, try to figure out stuff, and try to get it all set up and correct. I see why they do have the leaning of the wheels as a suggestion when you build, because I've noticed with anybody's, or with most builds, like the wheels, what'll happen is later on they will kind of, it'll flip over the car because they're straight for some reason. Which I don't know why. That it's a very weird thing to have happen, but I guess it's just the way that the vehicle was designed. It was just designed more for modeling than actual driving, so that's why my crawlers, my line basically, are the crawlers right now. That's why they have the kind of, they go inwards inside of the stuff. Where the hell is it? I actually don't know where the zombies are, and they're missing. They're just not here. Are they stuck inside one of the vehicles? I'm sorry, guys. Like, this is confusing me. I don't know where they are right now. In fact, I might just end this video just because of this. Because this is very confusing. Like, I'm trying to find some zombies. The last 3 of them. And they're all missing right now. Again, this is an early access, which I feel like the zombies are missing. So, we're gonna end match. Yep. Okay, well, I'll go in sandbox. I think I'm all alone now because of, yeah. I don't know, I might build and see how that goes. Okay, so what I'm thinking. Start out with this. I actually want to do a army camo for this. Because I don't normally use army camo and some of the other stuff. Okay, so that's this right here. No, that won't work. We need a 10. So like that. I don't understand what one. Oh, wait. Probably to that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a fast motor on this because I'm pretty sure a fast motor would work for this because I really don't need a diesel motor. I'm not doing anything. We'll put an exhaust on it too. Normally whenever I do my builds, I don't normally put in like any of the really high tier type stuff, like the high tier motors, like the trucker motor, because really I don't need it. I usually just use the fast motor because it's pretty decently fast and it can get the job done by itself. And then we'll just enclose this. Copy that. Put that right there. Okay, copy up. We might have to do two. I don't know. Maybe. Okay, here's the seat. We'll do a passenger seat. We just need, we're gonna set this up to where it's like a three-man team type deal. Or maybe not. You know what? We need a wider base on this. That's what I feel like. We need something bigger. Here, delete that real quick. So, 8x8. Do an 8x8 right there. Because we need something big and wide to show, hey, this, you know, this is how that is. Okay. And see, that's going to be like the platform. We need to, I don't know. Guess we might need two of these. Copy, paste. Yeah, there we go. Now we can put the fast motor on here because it's not carrying anything heavy. Actually, I want to do a different light for this. I'm just trying to get some lights down on this because then we can illuminate the piece of this so it lights up. Good boy. What is it? What are you whining about? What? Up. Okay. G, there we go. So there's like our base piece of it right now. Let's see. We need to put actuators and that type of stuff on this, but I need to figure out how I'm gonna do this because we need to do this in such a way. In fact, I might go to the 8s. Let's go to the 8s on this. We need a little bit more space in between. Copy that. Do another 8. There we go. Okay. Do we want to use these? Actually, want to be over here. See, we could use this, or what else can we use? We can use this, But that's a really small one, and that's a really big one. The bigger one should only be really used for a turn. That's what I usually use it for, but that's all I use it for. Oh, don't do that. There. Copy that. Mirror. Select all that. Copy. I'll have to see about which way these are all going, though, because of the whole deal that these are not going all in the same direction. I know they aren't. For sure, I know they aren't. Copy that, bring it over here. And that basically matches up pretty well. I mean, not all the way, but it does match up. I don't know. How am I gonna do this? Because also need to put a seat down. Okay, is there a block that I don't think there is. I was about to say if there's a block that's kind of like a pump that kind of like just it kind of it's kind of like within a block within a block type build. That would help, but I don't think we have any of those in Berkrigs, sadly. But I'll work with what we have. Okay, down. That's one right there. What the hell? Ah, god damn it. I think, yeah, it is. For now, we'll just put it on there. Should match up pretty well. I don't know if this would work really well or not. I need something like a spire. Wait. I got an idea. Get rid of all this. I got a better idea for this. So, on these sides right here, the spider-like technique, I have copy this. Copy this, put it over here. Just now thought. Print some spider leg type versions on this side. Nope, not that. First this. copy that, bring it back. We'll do this seat actually a green, like a black. Okay, now we can do it. So what I just now thought of is do, instead of like what I was trying to do earlier, which wouldn't have worked very well because it would have been off balanced, like a ton, instead take these and do that. And see, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna end up taking that, putting the rotating blocks on it, the actuators. Not that. And then putting this on it. And then we'll bring these up. Two right there, which this one didn't do it correctly at all. There we go. That's fixed. Now we can do what we were trying to do. Which basically, I do need to see which direction they're going, because it doesn't really tell you where it turns, which really sucks. But we will find out from this little test soon. Copy. Put that back. Okay, yeah, that's fine. Okay, so that one goes in the right direction. That one isn't connected. That one isn't. So I think that this one's on a positive. These two aren't correct. Let's fix that real quick. Okay, try again. Okay. Positive. Positive. These two are negatives. So let's do this as a negative 90. These two. Oh wait, no, it does show me now. That really helps. Okay, let's try this. So if I tried, I might have to fix this. Yeah, that's the minimum. I need the max. Negative 90. Right? Oh no, it's not gonna do it because of that, isn't it? Let's see. Question, what? Okay, so 90. Negative 90? Can we? No, it won't allow us. I'm trying to think then. Can we do, because if we do 90 on that, let me do 90 on this. Can we, oh wait, can we not do 90 on that? Oh, well then we can't. Wait. Negative one. Can we do negative one speed? I'm just trying to get it to flip. We can do negative one speed. Let's see if that helps. Negative one speed. Yeah, go ahead. It should be fine. There we go. So that should help. So then, we just gotta figure out how we're gonna finish this out because I gotta make it to where it rolls. Then we also gotta make it to where it kinda like sets up itself. So, let's see how long this video is. I'm gonna go ahead and end it there. I will show you guys the finished results next time. Bye!